people are siphoning off billions of dollars of oil in addition to that, that is supposed to be helping the Iraqi people? Sounds like an unconscionable criminal enterprise in which we've all conspired. Do we have any idea who's benefiting from all this?
I think it's pretty clear from both the published reports that I've read and the classified reports that I've read that corruption in the oil sector is pretty pervasive at all levels of the industry.
And explain to me, as I understand, there are 15, no less than 15, that's more than a dozen and a quarter, paid American consultants overseeing this enterprise. Who do these consultants work for? What agencies?
Well, if you're referring to the advisors, the U.S. has about 20 advisors working with the Minister of Oil.
And what's their job then?
What do they do? Well, one of the problems that all the ministries have is that they don't know how to execute budgets. They don't know how to spend their budget. They don't have good contracts and procurement rules. And all
they couldn't even figure out how to execute the dictate.
Pardon?
It was a quip. Tell me again what they're supposed to do.
One of the key things that all the advisors, and of course I'm speaking from my observations as part of the legislative branch, not as from the administration's perspective, is that they're trying to help them execute their budgets. As you noted in your opening statement, Minister of Oil only spent $90 million out of the $3.5 billion they set aside for oil projects.
And they need advisors to tell them how to do this the way they're doing it?
They don't know how, according to the advisors, they don't have good skills and good technical skills in terms of letting contracts, issuing contracts. They don't know what their bidding is. The World Bank has even commented on the difficulties they have in trying to explain true competitive bidding procedures with Iraqi officials.
Somebody better call the cops. There's something bad going on here. I just don't understand this. How are we letting them get away with this? How are they getting away with this? How are the Iraqi people allowing them to get away with this? What are these advisors doing? Are they following the advice the advisors are advising?
One thing that we're actually going to be issuing a report in about 6 weeks, looking at all what the advisors are doing. And I think one of the challenges the advisors have found is that oftentimes the Iraqis don't take their advice because they have their own agendas in terms of what they want to achieve.
Wow. This is beyond criticism. It's hard to get a handle on even what end to approach this problem with. It seems so huge and immense. How did it get so out of hand? Do we suspect that this system was that bad under Saddam Hussein?
Oh, absolutely. In fact, Mr. Galvin, you recall the hearings we had on the oil for food program. GAO at the time estimated that up to 480,000 barrels of oil was smuggled out of Iraq.
Yeah, but we know who got the money then.
A variety of companies as well as the Iraqi government.
And who's getting it now?
Unclear.
How do we get it clearer?
You can get clearer with some additional classified information, certainly.
Classified information to indicate us who's getting rich? How this is getting done?
Indicate the pervasiveness of the problem, yes.
I think we've got a flavor of the pervasiveness of the problem. This is world-class racketeering that we're in charge of advising. Yeah, this is an international RICO kind of deal. It's absolutely mind-boggling. I think I've used my 5 minutes in amazing.